Hey guys, welcome back. This is Bernard from the BTNHD, and today is all about capturing a SmartDeploy reference virtual machine within Server 2019. On the last episode, I showed you guys how to create a SmartDeploy virtual machine, and today is all about capturing it. So let's get started. Within HyperV, I created a virtual machine that I called the BTNHD SD template. And within there, I installed all types of programs. I pushed out all the Windows updates. Everything was fully installed. And one of the recommendations on creating a reference virtual machine is just to shut it down. You don't need to do a SIP prep. So that's what I did. I clicked on start, power, shut down, and I shut down the machine normally. Once SmartDeploy is up and running, click on reimage devices, and we need to click on capture image. It's going to start loading up and you're going to get the captured wizard. Click on next. It's going to want you to browse to the virtual disk. If you click on browse, it's going to automatically go inside the SmartDeploy reference machines folder. Now, this is the BTNHD reference machine that I created with you guys on the last part when I created it with VMware Workstation, but we're not going to use that. So I'm going to go inside my C drive VMs, and there goes my VHDX file that I just created. I'm going to select it, hit open, click next. It's going to start scanning the disk. It's going to start searching for the operating system, and then boom, right? For this to work correctly, do not SIP prep that machine. Just shut it down normally. Once everything is scanned, take a look at this. You have an option to use WDS, Windows Deployment Services. I'm not going to actually touch base on that as of yet. So I'm gonna leave everything as the default and just click on next. Provide a local administrative account and confirm it. You are able to provide the product key here, but I'm not. Click next. You have two options. I'm going to pick the default one, which is standard image, then click next. From here, I'm going to click on browse, and it wants to drop this image inside the images folder within the SmartDeploy folder. So I'm definitely going to click on save, give the image a name, give it a description if you want, and then click on next and then hit finish. It's going to start capturing the image. It's going to start processing it. If you want, you could actually go inside the images folder and you will see your WIM file right there. Again, it takes a while. It took about 25 to 30 minutes for this process to capture and complete. Once everything is done, you should get this nice little dialog box saying the image was captured successfully. Just click OK. Now, all your images within SmartDeploy are actually located within reference machines, and you're going to see your reference machine. From here, you are actually able to click on the plus sign, and you only have two options. You can actually create a reference machine or import a reference machine. If you select your reference machine and right click on it, you have a bunch of options: capture, remove, or open a file location, or refresh it. And that's it, guys. That is how we capture your reference image within SmartDeploy. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that like button, also comment right below. Don't forget about punching, elbow, and smashing that subscribe button to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next part. Peace out. Why, hello, welcome. So if you guys are tuning in to the SmartDeploy mini-series that I have been creating for you guys, believe it or not, I could get you guys a awesome deal. On your desktop, we are going to open up our favorite browser. I'm going to open up Google Chrome. We're going to type in smartdeploy.com/BTNHD. Hit enter. It's going to take you here, and you are able to get a free license to manage 15 machines for free forever. Just click on that button that says get free licenses. It's going to take you here. You're going to enter your business email address and hit that get subscription button. And once that's done, wait about 3 days. You will receive an email from SmartDeploy to continue your subscription. And that's it.